Warning, liberals just launched major move to dismantle Electoral College, America is doomed. Democrats have a plan to unseat Donald Trump in the 2020 election, and it's very simple, amend the Constitution. When Donald Trump accused the Democrats of plotting voter fraud and called the legitimacy of the election into question, they railed him for remarks that they alleged undermined the very fabric of American democracy. But nanoseconds after the votes were tallied and they realized with stark horror that Donald Trump had won the presidential election, it was the Democrats who unleashed a full-fledged assault on the electoral process, concocting conspiracies of Russian hackers cheating the election and decrying the Electoral College as oppressive. There is a lot of doubt that the Electoral College could ever be repealed. It would take a constitutional amendment to do so, and would be very difficult. But there is evidence that the Democrats just made a major one-up in that direction. Liberal professor Lawrence Lessig, who frequently wrote op-eds criticizing the Electoral College, has made a move to bring his case to the courtroom, and it's frighteningly close to happening. Lessig is advancing his cause with a perversion of our Constitution, arguing that the Electoral College violates the 14th Amendment's one man, one vote principle. But instead of outright eliminating the Electoral College, Lessig will chip away at it by proposing, instead of a winner-take-all system, to give each candidate a percentage of the delegates based on their results in each state. If he were to defeat the odds and prevail in his lawsuit, the changes in American democracy would be revolutionary and catastrophic. A small number of urban centers, infested with Democrats, would have total lordship over the rest of suburban and rural America, which is much more patriotic. Previous attempts by the Democrats to destroy the Electoral College have failed. Until the delegates came together to vote for the president in December, liberals still nursed dreams that some of the Republican electors would be turncoats and vote for Clinton. Not only did that never happen, but four Democratic electors betrayed their kind and voted for Trump instead. Now the Democrats have unleashed a full-scale assault against the Electoral College outlined in our Constitution. In a Fox News report, Hillary Clinton has declared that she intends to eliminate the system. Michael Moore lambasted the Electoral College as an archaic thing that has got to go. In terms of the popular vote, that was still a close call, Clinton with 48.5% and Trump with 46.4%. Funny thing is, even under a one-man, one-vote system, Trump could have probably still won the 2016 election. Democrats need to be honest, they're only going after the Electoral College because it caused them to lose the election. Had Hillary Clinton not even won the popular vote, she just racked up a huge score in two high population, obviously Democrat strongholds, New York and California. The Democrats seemed perfectly fine with the Electoral College when it helped them win the 2012 election, otherwise, it would have given Mitt Romney the victory over Obama. But they don't like to talk about that too much now, do they?